now we're off to Williamsburg, another one of our favorite places.
The story of the French and Indian War begins in several places, one of them being Williamsburg, Virginia. In 1752, the Marquis Duquesne was made Governor General of New France with specific instructions to take control of the Ohio Valley. At the same time, in Williamsburg, Robert Dinwiddie, Lieutenant Governor of Virginia, was granting land in the Ohio Valley to members of his British colony. Upon hearing that the French had built forts in the region, Governor Dinwiddie dispatched a young officer in the Virginia militia, George Washington, to deliver a letter demanding withdrawal of all French forces from the area. This mission would lead 21-year-old Major Washington on a journey of several hundred miles across uncharted terrain. He nearly reached Lake Erie when he was finally able to present the letter to Captain Legardeur de Saint-Pierre. The captain's response was to forward the letter to the Marquis Duquesne in Montreal.
This weapon in the hands of a trained British soldier give about 4 shots a minute.
It's a paper cartridge, and it allows you to load and fire your gun in 15 seconds. The other option is use a powder horn and a measure. And when people are shooting at you, it's going to take way too much time. So you want to be quick, so you use a paper cartridge.
You've seen the pictures of how the British soldiers fight. They always fight in those dense packed formations. Simple reason for that. When you get all those men together firing in the same direction at the same time, it's like shooting a shotgun.
Basically what you're going to do, you're going to put a bullet right here, but I'm making blanks, but the bullet would go here, and then once you create the tube, what you're going to do is you're going to bite it off, put a few grains of powder here in the pan, and then take the rest of the tube and put it down in the barrel, and you're going to push it down with your ramrod.
When people ride on the C&O Canal towpath northwest to Cumberland, they are basically following the same route taken by George Washington. This cycling trail now continues on via the Great Allegheny Passage all the way to Pittsburgh. It is the same route taken before and during the French and Indian War. Our travels now take us toward the end of the C&O Canal in Cumberland, Maryland. This, however, is not the end of our journey. We will continue to follow the trail of George Washington on his way to Fort Duquesne. The main reason to stop in Cumberland is to visit another headquarters used by Washington during the French and Indian War, and then again during the Whiskey Rebellion.
Cumberland. Right up ahead is the end of the line. That's the Western Maryland Railroad.
In another edition of our series, we will show how the C&O Canal and other similar canals were overtaken by the railroads. leave the train station and go across the bridge, we arrive at Washington's headquarters.
It's considered the most historical building associated with our first president's military career. It was here that he began his first appointment as aide-de-camp to the English General Braddock on May 10, 1755. His chief assignment was to keep the headquarters orderly book up to date and to attend the general's levee each morning between 10 and 11 o'clock. We assume the cabin was constructed at this time. General Braddock's defeat and death near Fort Duquesne brought panic to the frontier settlements, and Washington recommended to Governor Dinwiddie that Fort Cumberland be leveled or turned over to Governor Sharp of Maryland. 2 years later, Maryland accepted full responsibility for maintenance of Fort Cumberland. So it was in the summer of 1758, Washington arrived here with 600 Virginians to rendezvous with General Forbes for a third attempt to drive Indians and French out of the Ohio Valley.